First of all, a brief introduction. So we are plan early. Phrases don't plan late, but plan early. It's a very subtle play. And our whole focus is on this concept of what we call smart, lean, BIM. And the definition is the right BIM at the right time, by the right people, but for the right reasons. And if you guys are familiar at employing and deploying and using BIM on projects or starting to, you'll know that you can use it for so many different things. You could use it for understanding the design from a marketing perspective and winning a project. You could also right the way through analyzing people movement, structural analysis, solar, all of the different ways of analyzing a building can be more automated. We can understand clashes and quantities and simulations, AR, VR, MR, all of these different ways of viewing, and then also in facilities and many more. But whilst that is a good thing, it also causes us a big challenge when we're creating models. So from the left-hand side to the right-hand side, these are all BIM. They are all models, 3D models, but they've got different amounts of elements, a different amount of maybe data, of accuracy, of information. And who is going to do what BIM at what point in time can sometimes be a big challenge. And when we're trying to use BIM to optimize, but if we create too much BIM too soon or too little BIM too late, then it can cause us problems. And if nobody knows what they're supposed to be doing, we can end up a lot of the time in duplicate effort. So in this example, we have the same light fixture being modeled by four different parties on a project. And that is wasteful, it is unnecessary, but it occurs a lot in our construction, in our design and construction industry. And those are common challenges. We could end up with out of sequence work, we end up with too many clashes, lots of rework, lots of conflicts, data that's very difficult to understand. And therefore this international standard comes along. It's our opportunity to really understand how we can standardize and provide more consistency and let teams build a plan with purpose so that they can execute and not have all of those wasteful problems that we introduced there. So the ISO 19650, probably you guys have had a small introduction to it, but the principle is that there are lots of workflows and lots of steps that are involved. This is the clause 5 unpacked in these 8 different steps, and each step has a set of requirements. And in order to be compliant, we need to follow this workflow. Well, as a result from that workflow, we end up with a set of documents as well. And those documents, they range from organizational and strategic based information requirements through project information requirements, exchange information requirements, asset information requirements, BIM execution plans, pre and post appointment, pre and post contract planning so that you can execute along the same lines with methods and procedures, responsibility matrices, whether it's a high level or a detailed responsibility matrix, task information delivery plans, master information delivery plans, RACI charts, who's responsible, accountable, consulted, informed, and so many others. But this is a list of quite a lot of documents that would be needed. So if you are overwhelmed, if you are one of those people sitting there going, oh my word, how do I even manage this? You're not the only one. There are many, many people in the same situation. And unfortunately, that's not the end of the problems. The industry from a BIM perspective has been supported by these leading software providers to create great authoring tools, great analysis tools, and great use of a model. So some of these tools you're probably using already. But one of the biggest challenges is that we've got to implement that whole workflow that we just described with all those documents, but we are still using planning and management tools that are not dedicated. They're not purpose-built for design and construction or BIM. And they end up being disconnected, not only from themselves, but also from the rest of the workflow. So how can we help? Sort of built, this is the situation in our industry, but how can we help? Well, there are a couple of different ways. The first is that we can consolidate all of those different tools and into one cloud-based, super efficient, and much easier to implement workflow. And the workflow is in 2 main parts that I'll share with you today. The first is the planning piece, and there are 3 modules to support that. And the second is in the controlling and making sure that you what you planned and contracted for is actually controlled and verified. So the first part is solving that technical challenge and making it more simple to implement in a dedicated tool set. And the second one is the content. So how do you get a good plan Well, you need sometimes templates in order to achieve that. So we're really lucky to have now, I think it's over 200 people in a review team from more than 30 countries that are the ones writing and revising and updating these templates based on every change that occurs in the international standards, every new idea that comes out from these experts around the world. And if you know somebody that would like to join the review team, there's a link at the bottom there that we welcome people in and their ideas to improve these templates. What happens is when you create a Planoly account, you can have access to all of those templates. So in this example, we are clicking on some of the templates to create documents. And this is what I'll walk you through in the software today. In the plan module, we have everything from the BIM execution planning, exchange information requirements, RACI diagrams, et cetera. In the scoping module, we'll see how we complement all of that method-based information requirements and procedures with the detailed requirements for assets and for systems and for information that is required from a contract perspective. And then we'll also show how you can filter that based on which appointment, which contract documents you want to create. And we can create contract documents and get them approved with an e-signature inside of the platform. And there's a whole bunch more that we'll cover, but just sort of putting it into perspective before we dig into the software. I'm sure that there are many questions, but the main one may